Can you tell us a bit about your character and what, beyond his extraordinary circumstance, makes him such an interesting character to unpack?
That's such a great question. So I play a character called Harry Polk. He's a 17-year-old guy, and the best way to describe Harry, he's the kind of guy to make the most noise in a room, but he's often the loneliest inside. And that, for me, struck a chord when I first read the scripts, because I feel like we all are ever-changing, ever-growing, and especially at that age, we can all remember trying to find out who we are. And I think that's the most exciting time about life as well. It's about making choices about who we are. And at the same time, we make certain choices, and then we must see what happens in terms of the consequences. And that's about growing. That's about learning. And I don't think we ever stop doing that, you know. And it goes back to the show. I don't think it's about a show that's for a younger audience per se. Or I don't think it's a teen romance. I think it's much more wider than that. It's about identity and people searching for themselves and being comfortable in their skin. And I feel like that, for me, was why I gravitated towards Harry. And out of the extraordinary things, I think, quite simply for me, it's just Harry's choices that strike me, and for why it was intriguing. It was the relationships that he has with his mum and his dad, and that's something new, and it was also challenging. So I just felt like, yeah, that was why I'd, you know, wanted to be attached.
You mentioned romance. It's not all this is about, but it is a big component. Can you talk a little bit about why these two characters need each other so much and what your experience was like working with your beautiful co-star?
Yeah, no, absolutely. Like I said, it's about characters searching for who they are. And ultimately, for Harry, he runs away because it's about the freedom to, you know, wanting to be himself, but at the same time, overcoming the responsibility of, you know, of that pressure of looking after and catering for his dad. He wants to work out who he is and find out that, you know, and I guess June brings out that, you know. June is his escapism, you know. She's the only person who can see Harry for who he is, and I feel like that's the one thing that you want in a partner. And working with Soroka, it was amazing. It just was. I feel like, you know, when we first did the audition and the chemistry tapes, it just clicked. And we both went on this journey where we're both overwhelmed and we were anxious and we would confide in each other. And it's quite similar to the characters, really. The fact that they are learning, growing and sharing so much, and dependent on each other as well, you know. So I feel like that sums up my whole experience. I did a show called Wizards vs. Aliens when I was about 18 years old, and that was with the Doctor Who guys. So I had a small, very small experience about how it works and stuff. But ultimately, you know, when we use sci-fi, it wasn't, a green screen that comes in halfway through the shot. It was about us physically working out the performances, the emotion, and then we apply the shifting aspect to it, you know. So and we did that, you know. We had amazing locations, like you said, you know. We was in Norway, Yorkshire, London, and each location gave a different energy, different feel to the show. And I feel like even in the shifting aspects to it as well, it has a different tone as well, you know. So ultimately the show is very grounded in the fact that's about the relationships, and the shifting and the sci-fi is added on top of that. It's not a teen drama. It's as simple as that. I feel like it's its own show, in the fact that I think shape-shifting, I feel like it hasn't been tackled in the way that we've done it, and just ultimately the story. But I feel like, yeah, Netflix allow us to have the creative freedom to create whatever shows we want to create, you know. And I feel like The Innocents can't be pigeonholed into anything, really. I feel like it's its own show, and I feel like when audiences do watch it, they'll see that.